I'm from Langley, and I want to talk to you about our community. And as people in healthcare, we talk a lot about stories. So what I'm going to hope to do today with you is share with you the story of our community. Dear to my heart because it's my hometown, but I think you'll find parallels to each of the communities that you come from. One of the parallels is we actually do get snow in our area too. But we have four lovely seasons. These are all photographs taken by our physician members who have lots of interests and skills in our area. But Langley is a bedroom community or suburb of Vancouver, so we're growing fast. We have over 100,000 people. So we have a problem that is really similar to, I think, lots of areas around Canada, and it's we simply do not have enough primary care providers, specifically family physicians. Wait times are long, you can't get in a timely way. Just actually getting a family physician can be very difficult, and problems, as we heard earlier today, can result from that. And this is an issue that is at the forefront both in our community and really in our province. A year ago, or a couple years ago, our Minister of Health in British Columbia made a pronouncement that by the end of 2015, every British Columbia who wanted a family physician would be able to have one. Now, that is hugely daunting. Our community, through an organization called the Langley Division of Family Practice, which is really a grassroots organization made up of primary care providers, of which I'm currently serving as the chair, we have taken on this challenge of trying to find family physicians for everyone who wants one. We've realized that we simply can't do it by minting more providers. There just aren't any to be had. We have to do things more efficiently. We have to do things differently. And this is actually where the technology piece comes right into play, because we think that has an enormous role. And part of the thing with the technology is, for a lot of people, it doesn't come naturally, and that's where the support comes in. So let's take you to a typical family practice in Langley, which really does look like a lot of other places. There's the EMR. Here's, unfortunately, one of our typical docs, because we do have an aging physician population. Roughly speaking, we have 100 GPs and 50 specialists. Our adoption rate by GPs in particular is remarkable. It's at 81%, which, as you heard earlier, is certainly above average, probably for Canada as well. Our specialist EMR adoption rate isn't quite so good, but it's coming along. But that sort of brings up a problem that I think a lot of people have, and that's vendor fragmentation. Even just in our little area, we have six different vendors, but the top two really carry a large part of the market share. They don't talk to each other. And they don't talk to each other. And really, that has become a bit of a problem. Bridget talked to you about the clinical value model, and we really have a great team in Langley made up of peer mentors, both of MOAs and physicians, as well as practice automation coaches and other people who are able to support physicians to learn and actually use their EMRs to the greatest extent possible. In cooperation with our division, we also try to put on user group nights and talk to the community about how they're using the EMR, what they could use better, but also give a chance for them to give that feedback in terms of what is frustrating them and what they would like to be able to do. To me, though, this really only encapsulates your use of the EMR within your four office walls, which has a very significant use. You can, if there's a new drug interaction, you can get it at it right away. If you want to know which one of your patients are due for certain preventative care, you can get to that right away. But that's really only the four walls of your office. We really don't communicate with each other in the healthcare system very well. I have to acknowledge there have been a lot of improvements in recent months from the hospital. I'm getting a lot of information. I can't give them any information back other than the old-fashioned pick up the phone or send a fax way. But really, our ability to interact and work with our nurse practitioners, our healthcare teams, is very limited. It is still very rudimentary in terms of how we get in touch with each other. Now, with respect to our specialist colleagues, I'm sure some of you will have specialists like these too. Sometimes talking to them is really difficult, and some of these are system problems. Getting appointments on time, getting a referral letter back, figuring out what they want, exchanging the information, those are all big challenges. And just because a specialist may have an EMR and I have an EMR and the two don't talk is really no better than each of us still being on a piece of paper. Back to the division and in terms of what we're wanting to do with getting a GP for everyone, we've looked at four specific populations in our area: moms and babies, mental health, frail elderly, and those with multimorbidities. And those are the areas we're focusing on to get family physicians, because these are likely the places where you have the greatest need. We've been doing a lot of work around engaging with our community, and for so long, our general practitioners have been feeling really unheard and isolated from the system. We've also had lots of discussions with our MOAs because we really believe that area of the office staff is an untapped resource. There's a lot of work and lot of skill and passion that they carry to our offices that we really want to use better. And they are often, they're literally at the front lines. They're the ones that answer our phones, speak to our patients first, and so we want to make them a much bigger part of our team. We've also been talking with other members of the health authority, government, all to try to bring this closer together and improve the coherence of our community. And a large part of our discussion is around information technology, particularly information technology that works where we can actually talk to each other. And that's really a huge challenge. So in my mind, the EMR know-how, where we each get to know how to use our EMRs that have in our environment, is great. But really, where we have to go next is a system integration, where each of our systems actually start talking to each other, where it's a two-way exchange of information, because that's really, I think, the only way to move forward and get to some of the things we need to be able to do. Thanks.